Hey, we're here with Joe Retta, who's going to be performing tonight at 2015, The Ox and the Loon. How are you?
I'm good. I'm great.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So what are you performing this evening?
A bunch of Who songs. I got like 6 songs to do. I can't think of them all right now, but
okay.
A handful of them.
Nice.
Plus harmonies on some other stuff, yeah.
Okay, right on.
Yeah.
So what's your favorite Who song? Not just to sing, but what's your favorite Who song?
Join Together.
Really?
And I am doing that one.
Okay, you remember that. That's good.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Awesome. Well, I look forward to hearing you this evening.
Well, thank you very much.
Oh, yeah. All right, you have yourself a good evening. Hey, I'm with Aaron Micklow, and you look amazing.
Thank you so much. You do too.
Oh, thank you. You're like into your hair. Me too. How long did it take you to do your hair?
Oh, my God, this is the question of the week at an hour.
Yeah, it took me an hour also.
Yeah? Used to take like 2.5, but
yeah,
down to an hour now.
Got it down. This is actually yesterday's hair.
This is actually 2 days ago hair. You just refix it every day. You kind of like bend one and sleep on it and then wake up and fix the broken ones.
Yeah. Well, you look amazing. I love your outfit.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. So what are you performing this evening?
Oh, I'm not performing. I'm just here attending and supporting the artists.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Awesome. So what is your favorite Who song?
God, probably My Generation, just because it's the most popular. Honestly, they're not my generation. I'm a little too young for that, so I only know the hits. And a lot of my favorite artists have covered their songs.
Right on. Well, you have yourself a wonderful evening. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you so much.
All right, state your name and your purpose here tonight.
I'm Joseph Pusateri, drummer extraordinaire.
Yes, you are.
Playing some Who music.
Okay, so what song are you playing this evening?
Can't Explain, kind of in the style of Live at Leeds.
Okay, awesome. How has Keith Moon influenced you?
Well, he was a pretty big influence, but I played in a band with John Entwistle for about 3 years here in L.A.
Nice.
Yeah, right before he was touring again. It was like a superstar band with Mickey Thomas on vocals, Jeff Baxter on guitar.
Right on.
And it lasted a while, but you know how bands go. It's like a Spinal Tap stuff happened, and it was all messed up then. But I hung out with the guy for a long time. He took me to his like castle in England, and I hung out with there for a couple of weeks in London. And so I know John really well. I miss him so much. But I don't know. I think I'm the only guy who actually played with someone with the Who on this thing.
And they'll say that tonight too.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe, you know.
They will.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you have a great evening.
Thank you. You too.
Thank
Good
you.
To see you.
Okay, we're back with Joe, and I forgot to say that he's the lead singer of Sweet in Heaven and Earth.
Yeah, and I wanted to mention that Heaven and Earth, we had a new record come out last spring, and we did a European tour, but we're having a new record out, and we have 2 new members, Kenny Aronoff and Lynn Sorensen from Bad Company, and Kenny, you know, from who played with everybody. So that's pretty exciting. And then,
that's super exciting, because Kenny's amazing.
Yeah, and then I got a call from Dio's Disciples, and I'm going to be playing, starting to play with them in May. So that's pretty cool, too. So yeah.
You're a busy guy.
It'll be a fun 2015.
All right, you got to state your name and state your purpose.
Yeah, my name is Oney Logan from the Lynch Mob, as well as the Dio Disciples. This is my beautiful girlfriend.
Ivy Ferguson, Playboy model.
So are you a centerfold or your model?
I'm a Playboy model for Playboy TV and Cyber Club.
Nice. Wonderful. My girlfriend was in Playboy. I love Playboy. But we're not here for Playboy. We're here for The Ox and the Loon.
Absolutely. Which last year I performed with them at the House of Blues with Brian Tichy, and it was a great honor. And so tonight we're just spectators and we're having fun, and it's our first night at NAMM, and we're already tired and we want to go home. But you know what? A few drinks won't. It's nothing but a few drinks won't fix.
Yeah. Well, you're gonna have a great time. Is there any particular Who song you're looking forward to hearing?
Rain on Me.
I love that one too.
Yeah.
That's because I'm a romantic. I also love Squeeze Box.
Squeeze Box is a great song, but do you know who sings that song?
Tonight?
Yeah.
Don't know. It's not Michael Devon.
Who?
It's not Pete Townsend.
No. Who is it?
It's the real Roger Daltrey.
Tonight? He's going to sing it?
Oh, yeah. He told me. He was coming.
Oh, come on. You're pulling my leg.
Yeah, he told me Geddy Lee was going to be here because I'm Canadian. Yeah, no.
I had to get her. The reason why I got her over here is because Geddy Lee was going to be here.
Yeah, he's like, Geddy Lee. I'm like, oh, Geddy Lee? Yeah, no.
You look like Crystal Hefner.
Oh, thank you. No, I don't.
I met Crystal. I actually interviewed her. She was my first red carpet interview. Yeah. She opened a club in Reno, and I met Crystal. And you look, at first I was like, oh, that's not Crystal. You look just like her. She's a love bug.
Yeah, I love her. She's so sweet.
Yeah, very cool. Well, look at that, Eric, a real Playboy model.
That's my camera guy, Eric.
And a real what?
Yeah.
Who is this guy?
Oni.
Logan, don't forget it. Peace out.
Peace out, homie. Bye. Thank you, guys. I'm here with the very handsome Sean McNabb. How are you?
I paid her to say that.
No, he didn't.
She's looking ravishing tonight.
Thank you.
How are you?
Good. I'm so glad you're here.
I'm so glad to be here. It's my second Ox and Loon.
Okay.
I'm totally stoked to be doing this. You know, for me, Entwistle is the whole reason I even play music or bass guitar. So, you know, we're here to pay homage to our heroes, play the great music of The Who, and this musical community gets to come together on this night and just pour it all out, rock and roll, pay tribute to our heroes. The whole reason that we're playing music are probably because of this band and these two guys.
Right. Yeah. So what song are you performing this evening?
I am doing Summertime Blues.
Nice.
And Bellboy.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, which is really cool. I'm stoked to be doing both. I'm playing with some great musicians.
Who's playing with you?
And I'm playing with everybody tonight. Corky Lang, I'm playing with Les Warner, Mitch Perry, Joe Retta, LeBlanc is a staple. You know, we're going to do some,
do some
damage.
Everybody on this bill is stellar. You know, I was just saying this last night on the red carpet, I was saying that there's no flunkies.
No, you know, everybody's top notch in this thing, and you know, that's the thing. The musicianship in The Who was off the chain, man. It was ridiculous, and you know, they were a three-piece band, so they did a lot of playing. And for me, Entwistle, you know, I became friends with him later in the 90s, and I think I told you the story last time, but he gave me the ultimate compliment of my life one night, and he pulled me aside after a gig, and he goes, "Sean, you're a good little bass player." And it just made my life, you know, because it's really cool when your heroes become your mentors, you know, it's just a beautiful experience to have, you know, and we're lucky to be able to have those kind of experiences.
That's wonderful.
And I miss him so much, and whenever I go into solo mode, I'm thinking of the Ox up there, and we're going to do that. If you've never seen the end of this show, we all blow a solo at the end.
Right.
And it's friggin' ridiculous.
No, Eric and I caught it at the House of Blues last year, and we were blown away because we were stuck. The House of Blues has a little press area, and you know, Dan and I, we were all up there, nice little children, and I told Eric, I said, break it down, we're going to that encore, and we were so stoked we did that.
Oh, if you missed...
We're naughty.
Well, if you missed the encore, then you totally missed
yeah,
out,
you
but...
You can't miss this encore.
You know, I really want to say that to Joe and Brian, to put these kind of shows on, you know, it just gives me faith in the musical community. It was like this in the 80s, you know, the bands were all tight and friends and everything, and I've been feeling that from this whole California Music Fest, and I just want to say thanks to those guys for, you know, this is a lot of work to put on these events. If you haven't done an event before, oh man, to produce one of these things is incredible. Schedules, rehearsal time, all this, production. I mean, they're wearing a lot of hats, and I want to say, you know, just a tip of the hat to you guys because you're doing a fantastic job. And
yes, they are.
And this thing is going to grow and keep growing every year, and you know, I think it's sky's the limit for the California Music Fest.
Right on. And thank you to Noel Kim, who organizes all the press
and
invites
it.
Us back every year.
And Lynn, and we love them. Believe me, this thing doesn't go on without those girls.
No. The ladies. All right. I better get you down. I can't hog you. I'd like to, but I can't. All right. Take care. Have
Thanks
fun
for
tonight.
Having me. All right.